Good morning, everybody. Happy Tuesday, October 17th. Some very big news this morning. To start with, I'm going to stick to my script and I'm going to go through the Russian losses for the last 24 hours. And then we're going to get right into the news, which is appears to be a good chunk of the Russian helicopter air force being wiped out in Berdyansk. So, to start off with the losses over the last 24 hours. The wipeout in Avdiivka continues. The Russians, I think, are still throwing meat and metal wave out of Avdiivka. They've lost 800 troops over the last 24 hours. They've lost 14 tanks, which is still a pretty good number. 20 APVs, a little on the low side. 26 artillery systems. I have run out of superlatives and descriptors. I don't know when they're going to officially run out of artillery systems, but we know the Ukrainians have more active artillery systems in country and or more a greater ability to fire shells than the Russians do. And the Ukrainian shells are typically 10 times more accurate. So the artillery systems keep getting wiped out for the Russians. And if you ever want to go online and just validate anything, just search for Russian soldiers complain, where is my artillery? You will find post after post after post of them saying that they have no artillery support or it shoots themselves in the back. 11 UAVs, two cruise missiles, and the Russians. Oh, look, President Zelensky said that you need to subscribe and share and like to both my Twitter X and as well as my YouTube channel. The link is right there. So if President Zelensky says you got to do it, that's what you got to do. The Russian losses have now exceeded $92 billion US estimated. This is my estimate based on calculations of value of the average equipment loss, specific high-end items, all that sort of thing. And helicopters are sitting at 317. I'm expecting that could go up as maybe 326. Who knows? So let's get into the news. Now, this is breaking. Kind of as we speak, information is coming out real time. But first of all, Anton Gerashenko shared that Operation Dragonfly of the Special Operations Forces of Ukraine struck enemy equipment in the airfields near the temporarily occupied Luhansk and Berdyansk. According to the latest data, losses in Berdyansk and Luhansk are as follows. 9 helicopters of various modifications, special equipment located at the airfields, air defense systems launcher, an ammunition depot. Airfield runways are damaged. The ammunition depot in Berdyansk detonated until 4 a.m. I don't know what time it started, but it was an ongoing detonation. Detonations in Luhansk until 11 a.m. I don't have information on the Luhansk airport yet, just so you know. But glory to the Ukraine warriors. So let's play this bad boy. So this, to me, appears to be burning 3 separate, 2 to 3, it looks like 3 separate burning areas. And then from that same sort of area, you can see it looks like either a secondary cook-off. I think that's a secondary cook-off. I don't know if that's air defense, but it could be air defense. Anyways. Now, the Russian military sources are claiming this is horrific, some of the worst of the war. So this is from Fighter Bomber, who is a Russian Air Force mil blogger, and he basically, he or they or whatever, says, it's not a good morning. The Kokols, which is a derogatory term for Ukrainians, attacked our airfield at night where the Army Aviation was based with a TASMs. That's when you're really excited about an ATACM. Sorry, that was bad. With ATACMs, like in the description, if you like my loser joke, one of the most serious blows of all time in the Northern Military District, if not the most serious. So again, that's a mil blogger. So But yes, if 9 helicopters were taken out on the ground along with everything else, then it is an active descriptor that it is one of the most serious aviation losses in Russian history since World War II. Just that. So here's another update from NOAA reports. The Russian Air Force, now this is, again, it's re-quoting the same source, but, excuse me, Russian Air Force affiliated channel Fighter Bomber confirms that there are losses among personnel and equipment after the attack this morning. So Fighter Bomber has also posted other things in Russian. I just don't have all of the direct translation. Calling it one of the most serious blows of all time. He claims that it was done by TACMs, which are not confirmed supplied to Ukraine yet. I will show you. You do not need to be claiming that this is a TACMs. There's a reason why. Okay, so here is a satellite imagery of the Berdyansk airfield on September 29th. New satellite imagery shows more than 20 Russian helicopters are at the airport in occupied Berdyansk. Russian forces continue. Why they continue to hold, to store, to park helicopters, especially in such close proximity to the front line when they know that they can be struck, is beyond me. You can see more than 30 revetments. These are all basically revetments where the helicopters are being stored. It's not the best satellite photos, but basically all of these little bumps and lumps that you're seeing in all of these different pictures, right there, right there, right there, right there. Those are all revetments and helicopters sprinkled all throughout the base, right? So this is what you'd consider a major... I don't know, major. It's a large helicopter base. It's a large concentration of helicopters. Now, we've always said that ATACMS would be a game changer. However, ATACMS is a very, very large, very, very expensive, and maybe slightly easier missile to shoot down, and it's got a 300-kilometer range. Relying on some Russian military mil blogger to... tell us what struck, unless he pulled the trigger or loaded it. I'm not going to rely on him. And I'll show you, first of all, this is NASA FIRMS. And so NASA FIRMS is basically Fire Information Radar Management, Fire Intensity, Fire Information Management System, Information Radar Management System. Anyways, I should have got that acronym straight in my head, but it basically picks out fires. So basically, when the firm satellites, come do their rotation, and they fly over a certain area, they look down, and if they pick up a fire, a heat source that I believe is 30 meters square or greater, and lasts for, I can't remember if it's longer than 15 minutes, but approximately that, then it'll register as a fire. And the firm satellite over the Berdyansk airport has registered 3 individual fires at that airport, which kind of matches up with what looked to be 3 fires on that video that we saw. So where is Berdyansk airport, you ask? Oh, well, it's near Berdyansk, obviously. So here is the front line. Here's the Black Sea. Here's occupied Russian territory. There's the city of Berdyansk. This is a very large city. It's a port city. And now I put these 3 little flames here just to match up with NASA FIRMS. But you can see it's a large airport, and no, if I zoom in, I can't. This satellite image. Let me try one more time. Oh, hang on. Oh, we got revetments here? I don't know. Are those helicopters? I didn't zoom in on that part of the airport before. I always find like satellite imagery is like spying almost, like it's kind of cool. typically helicopters are not hidden away on the runway side of things, because they don't need a runway. Obviously, they just take off straight up and down, so they can be anywhere on the airport. And that's what kills me. So if anybody, any Russians are listening, I want you to do earmuffs right now. Cover your ears. But given the fact that her helicopter obviously is vertical takeoff and landing, therefore you don't need to be in an airport per se. You could be in someone's backyard if it was big enough. Why wouldn't you spread out your helicopters into hidden areas, residential districts, whatever, you know? Like, but no, pack them all in together, pack 30 of them into one airport. So when you look at the distance and you say, all right, Spartan, well, you're wrong, because it has to be a TACAMS, because that looks like really, really far. Here is the distance from what would be maybe a slightly safe area inside Ukrainian held territory down to Berdyansk Airport, and that is 94 kilometers. The ATACMS has a 300 kilometer range. So yes, it's well within that range. However, like I said, very expensive missiles, typically against hard targets. If you talk about HIMARS, like the regular Gimlers missiles that are coming out of the HIMARS, well, those are roughly 84 kilometers. So it's at the end of its range and probably out of its range for the standard Gimlers rockets. So to safely hit this, you need something that's going to go about 100 kilometers or more to safely hit that. What in their arsenal right now, in Ukraine's arsenal right now, do we know about that goes over 100 kilometers or more? You're kind of into the storm shadow and scalp range. Would they use those on helicopters? Sure. Helicopters are very expensive, high-end pieces of equipment. However, the storm shadow and scalp are very, very effective against also hard targets like bridges, Kerch, etc., right? So if you had something else that was in the news recently that you could basically use in replacement of a scalp, a storm shadow, or an ATACMS, oh, by the way, the scalp and storm shadow are like 250 kilometers plus, depending on which variant they have. So that's an easy peasy. But in the news just recently, Boeing and Saab came out and basically said that the ground launch small diameter bombs, the GLSDBs, are going to be arriving in country soon. Now, what I've always laughed about is when somebody has said something might be coming soon, some of the times with the Western equipment, it's already been in country, and it's basically just kind of like an official, unofficial announcement, floating a trial balloon, or maybe even a little OPSEC or PSYOPS, actually, with the Russians, basically saying, hey, it's coming in the future, and they've already got it. So the ground launch small diameter bombs, as I covered in a couple of other streams, are basically a combination of a rocket, a dumb bomb, a glide kit, and a GPS navigation kit. You put it all together, and you got yourself a $50,000 missile that has a 150 kilometer range. So not only would it hit Berdyansk Airport, it would go out into the sea. They're cheap. There are thousands of them that are going to be coming. There are upwards of 300,000 rockets available, hundreds of thousands of bombs available. So it just depends on how many GPS glide kits you can build and put together and slap it all together. So what do I think possibly hit this airport because of its distance mainly and because of the cost effectiveness? I would say number 1A would be GLSDBs. They're very, very difficult to shoot out of the sky. They can basically steer their way into targets. They can have their ballistic curve can be flattened out. They can glide forever. etc. They can actually do a 360 degree turn on target, so they can go past the target, come around and strike it from the direction that they came from originally, or they can come in from the backside 180 degrees. So if you had all of the air defense systems, for example, and radars set up in an arc this way, facing this way, potentially the GLSDB could come out past it and glide in behind. Right? That's the creativity of it. It can fly underneath bridges. It can hit cave entrances from the backside, etc. So I'm not saying I know for sure. Take everything with a grain of salt. But what I will tell you is I don't believe they dropped $3 million missiles on this airport, but they could have. But I do believe that there's a strong chance that this is the first instance of the GLSDBs, given the number of targets that were hit and the with the area on the airport that must have been hit to hit 9 helicopters, because those helicopters are typically 50 meters, 60 meters apart. So you're talking, if 9 helicopters, if you think about the spread on those helicopters, plus ammo depots, plus personnel, plus anti-aircraft systems. So to hit all of those multiple targets, sounds like it would have taken 5, 6, 7 cruise missiles, which would have been very expensive, or 5, 6, 7, 9 GLSDBs, which would have been very cheap. And the GLSDBs can be launched from their own launchers as well as from the HIMARS and the Mars launchers. So so there you go. Something to watch. Going on to other news real quick. This is the Army of Drones summary. I kind of like this summary. It's basically giving credit just to the drone hits over the last week. October 9th to 16th, took out radar and radio equipment, 30 of them, 178 strong points, 13 ammunition and fuel warehouses, 206 personnel, 2 mortar ATGM machine guns, 1 multiple launch rocket system, 75 tanks, 88 armored vehicles, 52 self-propelled artillery, 77 trucks and special equipment, 101 guns of varying types, and 2 air defense systems. That is the Army of Drones, kicking butt and taking names. If you're watching this, drop in the chat what I said the special operation was called that took out the Russian airbase. I said it at the start of the stream. This is a test. I wanted to show you just kind of a cool, high-quality drone video of additional armor and tanks being taken out in the Avdiivka area. Music, I don't know. So you got one tank hit, taken out, something's hit there, got something hit over there. Oh my goodness, I didn't watch this whole thing through. I watched the first part. I thought it was really just that one piece. There's another arty strike there, another arty strike there. Like, the accuracy of the artillery, it's just, please be safe videos, please be safe videos. There's a bomb droplet, he's okay, missed him. There's troops basically saying, oh, look at that carnage. Something's wiped out there, 2 to 3 vehicles there, a BMP there, BMP, BMP. There's an FPV drone coming in to finish off something. Tank, that was a turret toss. Wow. This is just a little FYI. Vladimir Putin is in China. He's now traveling. He's brave enough to travel. He's in Beijing for China's third Belt and Road Forum. It's basically their attempt to take over world trade corridors and, you know, lending money out to countries that need it to build their infrastructure, but then giving them a deal that they can't refuse. And then when they can't pay it back, basically, they've kind of owned their ports, the railways, that sort of thing. Italy, I think, has bailed out of that, which is great. The goal is to connect Asia, Africa, and Europe through a network of infrastructure projects. The initiative was considered as a way to expand China's influence and economic interests in the world. India is doing the same thing, but India's is called the Pearl Necklace, I believe, and it's looking to strangle the Belt and Road Initiative. You recall the last time Putin visited China. Here's a picture of that. Just let that kind of sink in. That is not Photoshop. That is a picture from Putin visiting China last time. No wonder Xi wants to have him back. Second last video here is a video of an FPV proving FPV, which is a first person view drone, proving that it is not only faster than vehicles, it's faster than motorcycles. Okay, that's annoying. But anyways, caught the motorcycle from behind. And this last one is a Russian BMP crew that got very, very lucky. So you're gonna have to watch close. It's about the midway point. I want you to watch here. And how close, so this is a Russian BMP firing on Ukrainian positions, and an ATGM flies over their head like a cruise missile. Just watch, and I'll... see if I can... Here it comes. Watch. Did you see that? Look at that. This is an ATGM fired at them. I think that's a javelin. There it is. Flew right over their heads. And there's a strike behind them. And it's like, go, go, go. So the cameraman actually knows that something flew over their heads. Luckiest men in Russia. I'm going to show one more time. Yeah. Look at that. Anyways, that's it. Don't want to end on a high note for Russia, but the rest of it is pretty good for Ukraine. So keep an eye on things. If I can report something later, I will. But to recap, Russian helicopters were wiped out off the map in Berdyansk and Luhansk region. There could be more to follow. Russian mill bloggers claiming it was one of the worst hits of the war. Could be 9 helicopters, 3 ammo depots, 1 anti-aircraft warfare system, multiple personnel. The losses could be quite staggering. And it could be the first instance of the GLSDB being used. So question everything that you see. Don't believe everything first blush. Don't believe me first blush. Question it, but keep an eye on the space. Anyways, that's it. Have a great day. Slava Ukraini.